Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Bhavna Joshi and I'm taking the subject Childhood and Growing Up. So in this subject, today we will be studying about the schemes and programs of Government of India for gender equity and equality in education. Now this topic is in your semester 4 of Childhood and Growing Up, B.Ed. 101. So let's start. Basically, it is very important to know that what do you mean by the word gender equity and equality. Now here the word gender equity means you are giving fair treatment to the women and men according to their respective needs. Now there is no discrimination on the basis of gender and you are giving equal treatment to the women and men as per their needs. Equivalent here means that equity, equivalent here means that there is equal right given, equal benefit given, and equal obligation and equal opportunities given to both the genders. So no matter what, from which gender you come, all the rights, benefits, obligations and opportunities are always equal in the eyes of law. Now, different behavior and aspiration and need of women and men are considered here. So they are valued and favored equally, and they are allowed to make choices without the limitations set by the, you know, stereotype and rigid gender roles and prejudice. So everything, the opportunities also, the obligations also, the benefits and the rights, all, everything is equal for both the genders. Now, the schemes and programs which are started by the Government of India, here is a list of programs, basically National Program of Education of Girls at elementary level, then Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya, Mahila Samakhya program, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, Sukanya Simriddhi account, One Stop Center scheme, Pradhan Mantri Ujwala Yojana, Mahila Ehat, Rajiv Gandhi National Credit Scheme, Maternity Benefit Scheme and Women Helpline. So these are a few schemes and programs started by Government of India. So let's start. The first one is the National Program for Education of Girls at Elementary Level. Now this program was launched in 2003 and this was basically implemented for the educationally backward blocks, and basically it was for the need of girls who are either in the school or they have gone out of the school, they have left the school. So basically this program deals with the prevention measures taken to reduce the dropout rate in our country, because it has been seen that the dropout rate in girls is very high. So NPEGEL basically emphasizes on the prevention of this dropout rate. Now, an important aspect of program is that to support and gender sensitize the classroom environment in the school. All the teachers as well as the peer group should be gender sensitive, and the girls should not drop out from the school. So this is about the National Program for Education of Girls at Elementary Level. Now the next scheme is Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya scheme. Now this is for residential, upper primary school. These are residential upper primary schools for girls, basically for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward classes and Muslim communities. They focus, categories are focused in this scheme, Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya. Now these schools, the scheme come up with a challenge to provide the security to the girls and compel them to discontinue their मतलब सॉरी दिस इज अ चैलेंज टू द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ द गर्ल्स बिकॉज मोस्टली व्हाट हैपेंस इज इन द रूरल एरियाज द स्कूल्स आर एट अ वेरी ग्रेट डिस्टेंस एंड इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर गर्ल्स टू गो टू स्कूल अलोन सो द मेन चैलेंज वॉज द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ गर्ल्स एंड विच ड्यू टू विच द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ गर्ल्स due to which they are compelled to discontinue their education. So high dropout rate is there in the rural areas. So this is the reason why Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya scheme come up to provide residential upper primary schools for girls for basically these communities. Now this Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya scheme reach out to the adolescent girls who are unable to go to school and out of school girls in the 10 plus group age, that is the upper primary. That means they are able to complete the primary education, but when they come to the upper primary education, 10 plus age group, they leave the school only because they are living in areas where the population is very scattered and the schools are very far away. Next is the Mahila Samakhya program. Now the Mahila Samakhya program was started in 1989 and this was for the education and empowerment of women in rural areas. That means to make the women socially and economically independent, this scheme come up with the for developing capacities in poor women so that gender and social barriers to education can be removed. Now, this scheme basically focused on the issues of health, education of women and girls, addressing public services and addressing issues of violence and social practices also. Now next scheme is Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Now this is for the upliftment of women in the sphere of women's education. Basically we have seen that in near past we have seen that the child sex ratio of girls is to boys. It has been seen that the girls ratio is going down. And still now, there are many, the inhuman practice of female infanticide is prevailing after 74 years of independence. So this scheme come up, was launched in January 2015. And this scheme focused on celebrating the birth of a child and every parent to be proud of their childbirth as they are proud of the boy's birth. So this is for the this scheme basically deals with all the measures with which this woman upliftment of women is, can be done by ensuring protection and survival of the girl's child and declining the child sex ratio. Next is the Sukanya Samriddhi account. Now, this was again launched in January 2015. And this scheme come up is meant for the families to save money for their daughters, for her future. Now, this scheme concentrate on helping families financially for their daughter's education and for the wedding expenses. Now, in this, what happens is the parents or the guardian, anyone can open an exclusive account in the name of their daughter in a bank or a post office with a minimum amount. So now a multiple deposit of any amount can be made every year till the child is up to the 14 years of age or 14 years. So from the date of opening. So now the deposit will get matured after the 21 years. Now, next is one stop center scheme. Now this is for this was this scheme come up with to meant for to offer easy access for women suffering from domestic abuse or violence and those who are needing support for this. So basically, this was for the women who are struggling from exploitation, torture, and violence. So this one-stop center was set up for offering immediate responses, emergency help needed by the women, medical support, and legal and psychological assistance to the affected women and girls, who even to the girls who are below the age of 18 years of age. Next is Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. Now, this scheme was launched in March 2016. Now, this was the step by the Government of India to give free LPG connection to the women even below poverty line, because women who are below poverty line, it is very difficult for them to get the LPG connection due to the high rates. So this Yojana come into being in March 2016, so that the free LPG connection is given to the women who are below the poverty line. Now, a lot of attention was given to this campaign, and it was said by our Honorable Prime Minister that those people who can leave the LPG subsidy should leave it for the upliftment of these weaker classes. So this scheme is very helpful for the women who are below poverty line. Not much requirement documents are required in it, and just an application, and you can get the connection. Next is Mahilaye Hayat. Now this is for empowering women entrepreneurs, NGOs, self-help groups, and small producers. Basically, this came in March 2016, and this was for the women entrepreneurs who are fighting hard in the world of men to get recognized for their effort, for their work which they are doing. So in this online marketing platform for women all over our country is done to showcase their products and services to the customers. Now this is in line with the Digital India and Startup India social campaign done by our Government of India. Next is Rajiv Gandhi National Credit Scheme. Now this was this scheme was come into being in the year of 2006. It has been seen that many talented and devoted mothers who are very much capable to do much more in their life, in their successful leave their successful careers just to look after their kids. So this scheme provided daycare facilities, improved nutrition, immunization facilities, sleeping facilities, and set the stage for better physical, mental, social growth of children of the working women, so that these women do not leave their career just for the sake of looking at their kids, but they go out to work, they find their identity, and are very much satisfied that their child is in safe hands. Next is the maternity benefit scheme. Again, this came earlier. It was known as Indira Gandhi Matritva Sahyog Yojana. It was renamed as Pradhan Mantri Matritva Vandana Yojana in 2017. And this was for to give benefit to the pregnant and lactating women in India. So an additional cash transfer, conditional cash transfer was done, is done to the women of 19 years and above, those who are expecting or lactating for the her first two live children. So I hope you all understood the all the schemes and yojanas which are started by our government of India for the equity, promoting gender equity and equality. Thank you so much.